You know, when you say to yourself that you're going to get started on Monday, but then Monday comes and then goes, and you haven't started on whatever fitness goal you may have? Well, today I'm going to talk to you about resetting for your fitness goals and looking at the mindset around resetting for yourself. Welcome. My name is Catherine Tanaka. I am a fitness, nutrition, and accountability coach and the host and producer of this podcast, The Body Project Podcast. I have the privilege of interviewing some of the top fitness and movement gurus in the industry about their origin stories and how they use movement, specifically fitness, as the access point to transform their clients' lives. I believe that fitness and movement is an amazing way to practice the discipline and the focus of for yourself that will translate into honoring your body through movement, honoring maybe the way you fuel your body, and then honoring the way you speak to yourself, that mindset muscle, right? And I really do believe that once you start practicing this for yourself, that you will then infiltrate all other aspects of your life. So on this podcast, we talk about exactly this. So welcome and thank you for joining me today. Today is part two of our four-part reset series. The reset series is really about looking at where you've been over the last several months during COVID and where you are going. And I believe that this conversation isn't really necessarily always a COVID conversation, right? Oftentimes in your fitness journey, it's all about the ebb and flow. There is no direct tangent line to attaining your fitness or weight loss health goal, right? I believe it is all about the baby steps of getting there, right? What can we do today that we can practice tomorrow that will move us forward to the point of which we feel like we are gaining success? And so the reset series is about that, right? But specifically right now, because of COVID, people since March have been in a little bit of uncertainty, maybe alarm, overwhelm, that has led many people to put their health, themselves, their fitness on the back burner, right? And now that we kind of know the trajectory of COVID, knowing that we are in this longer than I personally anticipated in the beginning, we know that now we can start navigating through our routine and through our lives in a way that can support, in a way that can support us, right? And so we're going to talk about this week. We're going to talk about how can you get back on track with your fitness? How can you reset that fitness button and start moving your body in a way that's going to support your health, your fitness, your goals that perhaps you had before COVID fell into the world, right? And we're going to talk a little bit about the mindset around your fitness goals and how this new normal may be throwing you off, right? Because now fitness looks a little bit different than it used to, and it may never look the same again, right? And so last week we spoke about what resetting is and what resetting might look like to you if you're feeling still overwhelmed and if you are feeling like you've maybe put on the COVID-19 or the quarantine 15 or all of these words that are going around. And if you are ready to get back on track with your health and your fitness because you're sick and tired of feeling sick and tired, right? And so today we're going to dive into fitness. And I want to break it down into three things of how you can get back on track, reset your fitness goals, reset how you're moving your body. If you've listened to this podcast before, you will know that I'm all about baby steps, about what can you do today that can accumulate day after day in this consistency that will get you to your results. And so with fitness, I really do believe that as physical beings, human beings, the physicality of fitness, excuse me, is super important. It really allows us to tie the practice and the discipline of moving our bodies to optimize our health, right? From a cellular level to the macro of your whole body, it is this really beautiful system of increasing the oxygen output and input of breath with adding resistance training or adding metabolic conditioning or whatever it is that you're doing to increase your fitness. This is fundamentally, and the evidence-based research will show you, a way that you stress your system in a way that allows growth and increase of strength, right? And if weight loss is one of your goals, fitness is also an important access point, right? Because yes, of course, you can lose weight with just changing your eating, honoring how you nourish your body. But I believe that fitness is that catalyst, is a powerful way to increase your results, right? Metabolically increasing your thermodynamic output with your body's muscles having to move and then consume more calories in order to sustain either the muscle mass or to sustain that output that you're having. And if you're looking to transform your body, you almost have to bridge the two. Fitness and nutrition, for me, work hand in hand and is this symbiotic relationship that is so important to advance, right? If you've listened to this podcast before, you will know that I always talk about mindset because sometimes the glass ceiling is of which, when you do have the fitness and the nutrition together, but you have these limiting beliefs piled on top of each other, these excuses that say you can't, these self-sabotaging thoughts or conversations of like that grade two teacher or that, you know, friend in college that was like, oh, I don't think you can, right? That we often live into or let our excuses stop us, whether it's kids or time or age or events or whatever it is, not believing in ourselves. That I believe that if you bring fitness, nutrition, and mindset, what we will talk about resetting over the next 3 weeks, you will attain your fitness, your health goal. So in terms of fitness, what can you do starting today if you are feeling like you don't know where to start? Right? For me, it's about, let's keep it simple. We're going to look at the plan. We're going to look at executing, and we're going to look at how can we prepare ourselves for success. So I would first say, create a plan. Even though our schedules are maybe a little looser if you're not fully back to work because of COVID, or if you have some flexibility in your schedule, or maybe not, I believe that if you honor your fitness and your movement time as part of your self-care, like you do going for a massage, like you do having a wine date with your friends, like you do meeting your friends for football, whatever sports thing you're watching on TV these days, I believe that you need to schedule your fitness in exactly that way. So make a plan. When this week can you carve out 30 minutes for yourself to show up for yourself, right? To show up for your health and fitness. In the midst of COVID and in the beginning of COVID, one of the things that I spoke about extensively is that our immune health, your health is your wealth right now, especially when we are threatened with this virus. And in saying that, you increasing your immune system's capacity from a strength capacity standpoint is super duper uber important, right? And in saying that, you taking this on and putting a plan in place really allows you, from not just a fitness or a weight loss goal, but from a health perspective, a longevity perspective, if you want to spend the most amount of time on this earth, ideally, right, then your health needs to be at the forefront, I believe, right? Because without our health, God forbid, right, we can't enjoy the things that we want to. And yes, it isn't easy, right? And it doesn't have to be this huge undertaking. It can be these baby steps. So my first step for you is make a plan. Grab your schedule, whether it's on your phone or if you do it old school way in a book, right? Find 3 days this week that you can schedule your workouts in. 3 days, give me 20 minutes. And I really believe that when you schedule it in and honor it like a business meeting, honor it like that meeting with your friends, honor it like whatever it is that you hold sacred, then that gives you some momentum. That also gives you the space to live into your best version, right? And then check in. Are you able to do this yourself? One of the things that I did when COVID hit was I pivoted my in-person studio. I run a studio where clients come to me that they come and do workouts with me, right? And what I had to do because of COVID was shut it down. But I completely pivoted and put my studio online. So I now have this online studio where my clients work with me 5 days a week live. We do live classes. They are metabolic and resistance classes, and they are fantastic. I'd like to say fantastic, but people say that they're fantastic and challenging, right? And in that challenge is this: it is accountability for you to show up. It is like that buddy system of holding you accountable, of making sure you're showing up, of challenging you to bring your A game. For example, in this morning's class, we ran a 45-minute metabolic conditioning class that is called legs and lungs, so cardio and legs. And in this conversation, at the end of our last finisher kind of hit portion, I actually called it out and I said, I know that you show up for yourself and this is the last little bit that you just need to stay here. And I do know that if I myself was doing the workout on my own, I probably would have skipped that little piece. And so ask yourself, are you the type of person that is self-motivated or do you need a buddy system? So find a buddy, even in the midst of COVID when we're still physical distancing and maybe you're not in the gym fully, you can call a friend. Find somebody that can support you through this, right? Because buddy systems, when you look at the research out there, it actually makes a difference. When somebody knows that you said, okay, Tiffany, I'm going to go on Monday and work out at 9 a.m. What about you? And you can play off of each other and support each other to hold each other accountable, right? If you want support, like I have inside my online studio, you are welcome to join us. I actually am going to be posting a special 1 week free if you are looking to do that anytime you want. The code will be, I think it's special. I will double check. And if not, I will make it so that it works. Special, it is at katherinesnacka.com/online studio. And then when you enter your details and you put the discount code in special, it'll give you your first week free. So if you want that support, if you want to check us out and see how we do it inside the Body Project Online Studio, I would love to have you in there. Now let's talk about preparedness, right? COVID has been challenging for many people, not only from overwhelm, but we've fallen into these bad habits, whether it's drinking every night like myself, right? Or maybe baking more than ever, making yummy meals, and therefore maybe we're indulging more than ever before, right? Or it could be that your schedule is completely all over the place, or it could be that your schedule is even busier than ever because if you are at the front line, sometimes you've had to work more than before, right? So how prepared are you to take on your fitness? And if you are unsure, check in. Is this a limiting belief? Because I do know that I do accountability coaching for a lot of people, executives that are super duper busy. So busy, in fact, that they come to me saying, I know my health needs to be a priority so I can facilitate for my team. However, I do not have the time and I don't know how, right? And so preparedness is really a mindset piece, right? So take a look at why is this important to you? Why is getting rid of that COVID-19 important to you? Why is your health being your wealth important to you? Is it because you want to be able to run around with your kids? Is it because you want to see your grandchildren grow up? Is it because you know that if you keep going on this path, you may get diabetes, you may have heart disease, and you know that that is a slippery slope to then recover from? So try to find what works for you, because losing 5 pounds isn't enough, right? What is the deeper why for yourself? I know for me, mine has changed many times over the years, but one of the fundamental reasons that I keep my body strong is that if you've listened to some of my episodes in the past, you will know that I have this really problematic spine. I have what's called spondylolisthesis. It's a grade 2, basically a vertebrae slip. if all your vertebrae are stacked on top of each other, mine is completely out of alignment. That is now impinging on all my nerves down my back. And it is a very fragile situation. Your body is very strong and resilient, but when the structural foundation of your body is out of course, things break down. So my why is that I want to be able to walk when I'm 90. I need my body to be strong and resilient so that I can sustain the trauma of a surgery. The recovery of this surgery specifically for my condition is at least 6 months, right? So my game that I'm playing, my big why, is that I need a strong body that can recover well from a surgery. I need a strong body so that I have muscle memory to live into after this surgery. I need a strong body so that I can walk when I'm 90. And the practice, guys, of fitness and movement, for me, is this discipline, is this mindset discipline. Because I mean, depending on, even if it's yoga, even if it's running, even if it's Zumba, there's some days you don't want to do it. There's some days that it's uncomfortable, right? And this getting comfortable with the discomfort is the game for me. Me being able to show up when I don't want to, me being able to challenge myself when it sucks, me being able to overcome that barrier of not wanting to, that barrier of it hurting, that barrier of saying, I don't want to do it anymore, that barrier, that mental game, the mindset of getting fitter and stronger and practicing the discipline and focus is the game for me also. Because I know that after I come back from surgery and I'm lying on that hospital bed and I'm in pain because they just had to rejig bones and they had to cage my spine, that my mind will want to slip to poor me, why me, this sucks, fuck this, being mad, right? But the practice of fitness for me is leaning in, welcoming that discomfort in a way to know that I am resilient, to know that I'm capable, to know that I am able. Right? And so this is part of the preparedness. Where is your mindset at right now? Where is your mindset for all of you looking at where you want to come out of COVID-19 at? Right? How do you want to feel coming out of it? How do you want to think coming out of it? How do you want to look in your body? Right? You don't have to be crazy fit, but how do you want to feel in your clothes? Do you want to be uncomfortable? Right? And this isn't always about weight. This is about how do you want to feel, right? Because we do know that how you move your body supports the healthy system, right? How you fuel your body supports the healthy system. It's this living, breathing, beautiful ecosystem, right? And then the final thing that I'll leave you with today is, how will you execute, right? I already spoke to you about the Body Project Online Studio, but what kind of feels good for you? And right now, especially because of COVID and everybody's stress level has been a little higher than normal, look at, you know, what feels good to you right now. Maybe it could be different than before. Maybe it could be an online dance class or a Zumba class or going for nightly walks with your neighbor, right? Or it could be a fitness class like mine. But remember this, and I spoke about this in the very beginning of COVID-19 on the podcast. Movement, specifically intense workouts, even if it's a short hit, like the high intensity interval training we do inside the Body Project podcast, I mean, Body Project Online Studio, or the metabolic conditioning that we do, these workouts help metabolize stress hormones in your system. Right? And so one of the things with, if you are feeling overwhelmed, if you are feeling anxious, if you are feeling stressed, you can move through that. You can help your body manage those emotions and dissipate it by actually metabolizing those stress hormones in your system, right? And so this is how I believe you can research, reset, make a plan, prepare yourself from a mental standpoint, as well as what do you need to prepare in your environment to allow for that to happen, and then execute, right? Three simple steps. So I'd love to hear from you. How are you resetting? Or what do you need to know to move yourself forward? In September, we will be doing a 12-week long Project You. This is a transformation program that actually used to be a 6-week program, but I've now extended it because what I do know, especially in times like this, is that we need community and we need support. And so I've specifically built this online program to do exactly that, to hold your hand, to hold you accountable, to cheer you on, to keep going, because I know you can. And when you start showing up for yourself, through fitness as the access point, with self-love and self-compassion, understanding that fitness and moving is health and health being your wealth, that this all lines up. And so if you want more details about that, you can join our newsletter at katherinetanaka.com. And if you want to find more out about the online studio, that's katherinetanaka.com/online-studio. But before you leave me, I'm going to tell you about what's coming up next week. Next week, we're going to be speaking about how can you reset in 3 simple steps your nutrition, right? COVID has brought around some really interesting new habits and, an abundance of some beautiful things. But sometimes with an abundance of, we consume in abundance, and sometimes that makes us feel lethargic, maybe changes the way that your digestion functions, and stress has changed the way that people are metabolizing and digesting in their gut health. And so we're going to look at how can we reset, how we nourish our bodies, and how can we switch it to a productive way. And if you're looking for a way to start resetting, if you are going to take on fitness right now, then I welcome you to join our free Green Shake Challenge. This is an amazing 7-day of shakes that you can do at home that are super simple and delicious that we've been running for years now, and people have been getting phenomenal results. So make sure you join us doing for that at www.katherinetanaka.com/Green Shake Challenge. You can find all the details wherever you're watching this. I thank you for your time, and I appreciate you tuning in week after week. We'll see you next week. Bye for now.